Hey, good evening. I'm Dan Fitzpatrick at StockMarketMentor.com on Tuesday. It's Thursday, December 12th. And I want to look at MasterCard today. As you probably know, yesterday before the open, maybe it was the night before that, I don't know. But the stock was up big time because they announced, in fact, I covered this just last night, I believe. They announced a 10-for-1 stock split. They jacked up their dividend by like 83%, and also announced an increase in their share buyback. So there's a lot of good stuff going on. And obviously, a boatload of people bought the stock yesterday at the open. A lot of buying going on. Look at the volume here. The first 5 minutes, over 300,000 shares traded. Okay, that's a pretty big deal. The first 5 minutes on the day before, a whopping 26,000 shares traded. So there were a lot of lemmings just rushing right in to buy this thing. And the stock just had been selling off. And you could have been tempted to start buying the stock yesterday. Like at the close or something like that. But let me show you a chart that I look at for these big ones, for the big movers. The outside Bollinger Band, the very outside one, is 3 standard deviations. So it's the bands, you know, you see the light gray area. Anything above that or below that is outside the norm by like 99.7%. In other words, stocks that blow out above the third standard deviation virtually always correct. Now, before you think that I just gave you the holy grail, look at this. This one blew out, or how about... Actually, let's just look at it the day before. I forget what happened there, but the stock, wow, gapped up above, out of these third standard deviation Bollinger Bands. Awesome short. Boom. You know, I suspect this was probably some, I remember what it was, but I don't need to go into detail. Visa did somewhat the same thing. But anyway, so it gapped up and then, boom, got slammed. So you're saying, okay, wow, I'm going to short the stock right here. I'm shorting the stock because it gapped up above the third standard deviation. Well, that needed to be a one-day wonder because the stock kept moving higher. So my point is, just because the stock opens and closes above this third standard deviation, don't look at it as a sure thing, but you can look at it as almost a sure thing because statistically, stock should be pulling back. It should fall back within the Bollinger Bands. But I have to say it again, statistically, not absolutely. Here, that method worked. So what are we going to do? Let me get back to the more traditional thing. Okay, stock's still outside the second standard deviation. It should correct more. Now, we could get the Bollinger Band moving higher to actually envelop the price, but either way you slice it, this stock is ultimately going to be back inside the upper Bollinger Band. So what do we do? Do we buy the stock now? No. The stock's drifting lower. I'm looking at this as a short-term low. We'll call it 781, but this is really the gap that you want to be looking at this day. The gap, like clear down to 770, if the stock happened to fill this gap, that's where you want to be buying the stock. It may not get down this far, but what I am saying is the further down the box this stock will go to where you can buy it gives you the most profit on the trade. I'm speaking the obvious. Hey, lower price you can buy the stock, the more chance you're going to have to make money. But the thing is, you want to be long the stock, but sometimes your emotions get the better of you and you just say, well, I got to buy this stock. Guess what? That's what all these guys did here. Okay, you don't want to be one of those guys. So wait for your turn. Wait for the right time to buy, and that's when you want to buy a stock like MasterCard. Okay, members, I've got about five or six what I call RHRN stocks. That's right here, right now stocks in the strategy session. So I want you to get over there now.